rolling and
Lewis has just wrecked my car.
Well, it was an accident. That's all right. Kind of stays.
My wife's just making a fantastic dinner.
Red, you look like a stripper. And you look, you always look like a stripper.
We're recording a video for Carla today with the boys.
We have to do this take again.
Oh. We just did it. Fuck. You're very mad now. Let's not film this. All right?
The reason why I got so mad here is because we took over half an hour to do one take that should have taken us about 2 minutes. But apparently, I work with children, so.
Rolling and.
You never ever find the right words. And there's no way to make kids.
Correct, so. Nick. You over? Cause
it's not gonna happen.
Way over the limit.
Way over the limit.
Way over the limit!
Again?
That's so good!
Eventually it got to the point where it wasn't even funny, we just got angry.
Way over the limit!
My voice cracked.
Oh, I fucked it. I'm gonna do-
And the car just went past up and fucked the shot.
No, there isn't!
It was at this moment that he knew. He fucked up.
We just wrapped up a 6 hour shoot that should have taken about 2 hours, and Khaled, still shooting.
He's getting B-roll of a paddock. There's no paddock in the fucking sketch.
But he's forcing Mateo to film a paddock.
He's gonna get home and be like, why do I have 8 hours of paddock?
Look, now he's filming a paddock on that side. Have you got enough paddock shots, Khaled?
We've gone over the limit
of
shots.
We got the C-roll and the D-roll. Are we done? Alright, woo!
We're done!
Let's get some food.
I think we're done. That's a wrap!
I should probably explain what was going on in that clip. So on my podcast, there was a worldwide hunt for a fat bird named Peter Pigeon. It went for weeks and weeks until we ended up going to his home, which was the Yarra River in Melbourne, and we recorded a live podcast trying to find him. I'm still impressed that I convinced 50 people to come out of their homes to look for a fat bird. You made your own blend of bird seed. So he's pulled out what looks like a bag of heroin. My favourite moment was probably when we sang our own version of Daryl Braithwaite's Horses. We did it as a last ditch attempt to seduce Peter Pigeon. There was even a dude wearing a pigeon mask twerking on a wombat. 1, 2, 3, so that's the way
it's gonna be, little darling. We'll be riding on the pigeons, yeah, yeah.
Squat. Yeah, I can never ever find the right word. So it's an awesome hotel room, sweet view, and then you get to this. What the fuck is that? That's the worst painting I've ever seen. It looks like a green grocery bag is going through an x-ray scanner at an airport.
It feels right, yeah. I'm only saying that it feels right.
Do a stunt. That's pretty good.
Life's short. Stunt.
It is currently 9:30 a.m. and I'm not even usually awake at this time, but I'm about to do a podcast interview over the phone with the Done Nothing Matter podcast. I just realized, who does podcasts this early? I'm supposed to be funny in about 5 minutes' time. Oh, I want to go back to bed. Thank you very much for having me. So at the end of some of these videos, I'm gonna try and put in some stand-up footage of crowd work from my shows. This first one was taken at the Sydney show. A guy named Alan sent my Facebook page a pretty cheeky message, so I decided to bring it up on stage.
Who's Alan? Is that your date? You're fucked. So Alan, so it was very kind, right? He sent me a cheeky message during the week. thank you for coming, by the way. very kind to bought two tickets for the show today. I'm taking a date. Hope you get me laid. Now, what was Adam's next name?
Erica.
Erica. What are the chances now?
50.
Dude, that's way better than I thought it was. 50 out of 1,000?